You know, I think at lunch we had a healthy discussion, and the discussion was over whether to move forward on repealing Obamacare. All of us promised we would repeal Obamacare, and the discussion is whether or not to move forward to a vote on that. We voted in 2015 to repeal Obamacare. I'm in favor of the motion to proceed to repealing Obamacare, and I think that's what we should do, and that's what the discussion's been about. There's an indication that that's the way we're leaning. There was some spirited discussion over whether we should move forward or not on the vote.
What is your message to those who have skepticism? I mean, we've talked to Senator Portman, we've talked to Senator Murkowski, and they may have voted last time, but now you're firing with live ammo, and that just does change the context.
Well, the message to the American public is Obamacare has failed. If you look at the individual market, if you're a plumber and your wife trying to buy insurance, Obamacare has failed you. The prices are rising double digits. In fact, 100% is the average. The prices have risen for those in the individual market. So Obamacare has failed. The death spiral of Obamacare continues. Even with partial repeal, Obamacare will still be in place, and Obamacare will still be a drag on the insurance markets and making it difficult for people to buy insurance.
But isn't that why they're a little bit reluctant? Because there is no firm commitment that they get something else. We saw what happened around here 6 years ago with the Super Committee, and that never worked out.
There have been many ideas for how we get more people in our country insurance. For example, 27 million people don't have insurance right now under Obamacare. The estimates are that 50% of those 27 million don't get it because it's too expensive. It's too expensive because of the Obamacare regulations. The death spiral of Obamacare is regulations make insurance expensive, and then you say, oh, but you can get it after you're sick. That is the real problem. That's the whole problem we have. It's the adverse selection and the death spiral. That's what we need to fix. We don't have enough votes to repeal all of that, so we're going to have to move forward, and I'm in favor of moving forward with partial repeal and continuing to work on trying to get rid of the rest of the bad elements of that Obamacare that have driven prices up.
Thanks, guys.
Do you think that there should be a vote that's
going to fail? No, I'm for a vote that succeeds, and I think those Republicans who promised to repeal Obamacare ought to vote the same way they voted in 2015. If you're not willing to vote the same way you voted in 2015, then you need to go back home and you need to explain to Republicans why you're no longer for repealing Obamacare. Thanks.
Thanks, Ed. Thank you.